Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. In this module, so far, you have all used the oval tool and the polygon tool to make many pictures. You also use the command function. Now, all of you go ahead and switch on your computers and open the MS Paint file. In today's class, what you will learn is how to type in an MS Paint file, how do we make use of the keyboard, how do we change the text style or the font name, and how do we change the writing of our text, how do we change the text or the font color, how to increase or decrease the text or the font size, how to make the text bold in italics and underlining it. You will learn about new, open, save and save as, and about the desktop background. You will get to know what are these and how they are used. And then you will learn about the options of the view menu bar, like zoom in, zoom out, ruler, grid lines, and about the status bar. Let us now begin today's class. First, all of you type about yourself on your paint sheet, or you may use the paragraph being shown to you. And take care that when you type in the paint sheet, your text box should always be there. If the text box gets removed, then you won't be able to do any formatting on the text or the paragraph. That is why you should make sure that the text box does not get removed after you have finished typing. Do you all know, after having typed text in the paint sheet, how you can change the writing of the text? In order to change the writing of the text in the paint sheet, you will need to make use of the option for font family. This will help you in changing the text writing. Can you tell what has to be done before you can change the writing of a text? By now, you would all know that to do any formatting on any text, you need to first select that line of text or paragraph. Only after you have selected the text or paragraph does your computer come to know that the changes have to be applied to this selected portion. Can you tell in how many ways we can select a line or some text or a paragraph? You can select any line, text or paragraph in three ways. First, with the help of the mouse or the touchpad. Secondly, with the help of the keyboard. For this, you need to use the shift key and the arrow keys. And thirdly, by using the shortcut command Ctrl plus A. Let us now see, with the help of the video, as to how we use these three methods to select the desired line, text or paragraph. Watch this video and see how we can use all three methods to select text on our page on the paint sheet. So, let's use the mouse and or the touchpad to select as the first option. So, for this, keep the pointer at the first place of the first line, and then with the left button pressed, drag it towards the right side so that the whole paragraph or the two lines get selected. To unselect, just click on the left button. Now, if you want to select from the end of the line, you can click at the end of the line with your pointer and then drag the mouse or the touchpad towards the left side and then up towards up direction so that both the lines are selected. Again, to unselect, just click on the left button. So this is one method of doing the selection. If you want to select only the second line, you will keep it the pointer in the beginning of the second line, click the left button and drag towards the right side till the whole line is selected. Now let's watch this video again and see how we can use the second method, which is using the shift key and the arrow buttons on our keyboard. For this, you need to position the pointer in the beginning of the first line and then keep the shift button pressed with your left hand, one finger, and press the right arrow key. And you can see that as you keep the left right arrow key pressed, the line gets selected that you want. You can continue so that the second line also gets selected. So you can use the shift and the right arrow key now to select these two lines or select the entire paragraph. To unselect it, just click with your left button inside the text box. Now let us see if we want to select from the end of this paragraph. So if the pointer is at the end, we can use the left arrow keys to bring it to the beginning of the line or position it where we want to position it by using the arrow keys. So now we are starting from the end of the last word. Keep the shift arrow key pressed with the left hand, and this time we are pressing the left arrow key so that we can select the entire two lines. So we keep pressing the shift key and the left arrow key till these two lines are selected. Again, if you want to unselect, you will just click inside the text box with the left arrow key. So this way you can use the shift key and the arrow keys to select. Use the third option, which is for shortcut method. To use the shortcut method, before that, let's see, we can also click on the beginning of the line, press the shift arrow key and press the down arrow to select both these lines. Also, if our pointer is at the end of the two lines, as has been already told, you can use the arrow keys to move the pointer. So let's bring the pointer to the end of the two lines using the arrow keys. And then here at the end of the second line, you can press the shift key and press the up arrow key to select both the lines. And you're also using the left arrow key. So this is how you can use the shift key and the arrow keys in various ways to select your text. To unselect it, just click inside the text box with the left button. Now we'll use the third option, which is the shortcut option, where you will just press the control key on the keyboard with one hand and look for the A key and press the A key. So control plus A, and it will select the entire paragraph on your paint page. So this way, by using control and pressing A together, you can select the entire paragraph. And now let us watch this video to understand how we can change the writing of any text. In this video, we will see how you can change the font style or the writing of your text. So for that, we need to first select, let's select the first line. You can use any method to select the first line. You can use the touchpad or the mouse and drag after pressing the left button, or you can use the shift and the arrow keys to select this line. After having selected the line, take your pointer to the format bar where this writing or the font styles appear. As is being shown in the video, click on the drop down button and you will see many font are appearing here. As you go in this, as you move the cursor down, you will see the change happening on the line that you have selected. You can also, this is called the font family, and you can use the drop down button or the button to take to the top side, or you can scroll up and down and choose the font that you want to apply on the selected line. If you want to change again, you will have to come back to this point here, click on the drop down button and then select the font that you want to apply. As soon as you click on the font that you want to apply, the font on the selected text will get applied and it will get changed. So this is how you can use the font family to change the style of the writing or to change the font. Let us now learn about the size of a text or a number. Can you tell how you can increase or decrease the size of the text or number that you may have typed in your paint file? In order to increase or decrease the size of the text or number, you need to use the option of font size. Can you all go ahead and show how you will increase and decrease the size of text or number? Let us now watch the video and learn the use of the font size option. This video shows us how we can change the font size of our text or numbers. For changing the font size, again you have to select the line or the paragraph or the text that you want to change the font size. In this video, you can see we are using the mouse or the touchpad, keeping it at the beginning and then dragging towards the right side to select. You can also use the shift and the arrow keys to select the line. After you have selected the line, you have to take your pointer to the font size option. You can see the font size written here. You can click on the drop down button. Now, as you take the pointer from the lower end to the higher end, the font size on the selected line also increases. And this is like a preview for you. So you can now select the size that you want, click on it, and that size will get applied to the line or the text that you have selected. So this way you can change the font size of the selected paragraph or the text or the line. Once again, let's see for the first part of the first line, which we had not selected earlier. Let's select that line now. Use any option to select this line. So now we are using the shift button and the right arrow key to select this line. After selecting, take the pointer to the font size option and click on the drop down button. You can see this happening in the video here. We click on the drop down button. You see many sizes, font sizes. And as you go from 9 to 10 to 11, these are the different sizes. As you take your pointer from the lower sizes to the bigger sizes, the size will also show on the line that you have selected. Now you can just select the size that you want and click on it, and that size will get applied to the line or text that you have selected. So this is how you can use the font size to make changes on the size of the font of the text or any numbers on your paint sheet. Let us now learn about how we can change the color of the text or number. In paint, in order to change the color of the text or number, you will make use of the color box 1. Let's watch the video to see how we can change the color of any text or number. Let us now see how we can change the font color of the text or number on our paint sheet. So again, to change the font color also, you need to select the text, the line or the paragraph, and you can use any of the methods to select. So we will first select this entire paragraph. We can do this by Ctrl plus A and then take a pointer to the color palette 1. As you move the pointer into different colors, you will see that the color is being shown to you as a preview. When you select that color, the color 1 changes to that selection and the same color applies to the selected text or paragraph. Again, if you want to change once again the color of some font or text, you can select that line or the text by using any of the methods for selection. You can use the shift key and the right arrow key as is being done in this video. After selecting, select the color that you want. By clicking on the color 1 will change and that particular color will get applied to the selected text or the line. As you can see, in this case, the green color has got applied. One more time, let's practice. Let's change the color of one more line. So we need to first select that line using any method of selection. Once that line gets selected, you can take your pointer to the color palette 1 and select the color that you want. We are selecting yellow this time. Color 1 changes to yellow and this same color yellow gets applied on the selected line as you can see. So this is how you can change the font color of the text or the numbers on your paint sheet. Next, you will learn about bold, italic and underline. Can you tell what happens when we use the bold option? Using the bold option, you can change your text to thicker and darker font. Can you tell what is the shortcut command for bold? The shortcut command for bold is Ctrl plus B. Now, all of you go ahead and show how you will make a line bold. If you still have any doubt about doing this, then watch the video and learn from it. This video will tell us how we can change the selected text to bold. So bold means it becomes thicker and darker. So first select the line or the text that you want to make bold as is being shown in the video. After selecting, take your pointer to the option which says B and click on that. As soon as you click, you can see the selected text has become bolder. It has become darker and thicker. You can select another line and see the effect once again. You can use any of the methods to select. So we select this last two lines. Take a pointer to the B option. Click there, left click on that, and you can see the change happening. It has become bold or thicker and darker. Once again, if you select this, the last two lines once again, just to see the boldness. If it's already bold and we click on B again, it will become bold. However, if we want to bring it back to its original position, then we can select this, these two lines again, and if they're already bold and then we click on B option, the bold operation will be removed and the line will appear in its normal view. So this is how you will use the bold option. Do you know what happens with the italics option? With the use of the italics option, you can make your text appear slanted or tilted. Do you all know the shortcut command for italics? The shortcut command for italics is Ctrl plus I. Now, go ahead and change any other line to italics. If you face a problem in doing this, then learn from the video. In this video, we will see the use of italics to change the text on our paint sheet to italics. So again, for changing to italics, we need to select the line or the text or the paragraph. Use any of the methods you know to select the line or the text that you want to change to italics. After selecting, bring the pointer to the I option and click on it. As soon as you click on the I option, you will see that the text that you had selected changes into italics, or that the text becomes tilted or slanted. So this is how you change any selected text into italics. If you select it again and then click on I again, it will come back to the normal view. So the italics gets removed and it comes back to the normal view. You can also use the shortcut command for italics, which is Ctrl plus I. So you just select the line that you want to change to italics. Either click on the I option or just use Ctrl plus I and it changes to italics. If you want to change it back, you will again use either click on the I option or use the Ctrl plus I command and it will change back to normal view. This is how you will be using the italics option. Can you tell what happens when we use the underline option? Using the underline option, you can get a line under the text or line or paragraph of your choice. Do you know what is the shortcut command for underline? The shortcut command for underline is Ctrl plus U. Now, go ahead and show how you will underline any of the other lines in your paint sheet. If you need help, watch the video. With this video, we will see how the underline option is used. To underline any text or line or paragraph, you first need to select the line. In this case, let us select the whole paragraph by using the shortcut method Ctrl plus A. After selecting the text or the paragraph, take your pointer to the U option and click on it. As soon as you click, you can see that all the text that you had selected gets underlined, or a line appears below the text. If you want to remove the underlining, you have to select the paragraph again, use Ctrl plus A, and then click on the U once again, U option. And you will see that the underline gets removed. You can also use the shortcut method, which is Ctrl plus U. So let's select a line or some text that we want to underline. And then by just typing Ctrl plus U, we can underline this line, as is being shown here in the video. Once you have underlined, you can see the underline has appeared. If you want to remove the underline, you will need to once again select the text which has been underlined, and then you can once again do Ctrl plus U or click on the U option to remove the underline. This is how you will use the underline option. You will next learn about some of the options of the file menu, like New, Open, Save, Save As, and Set as Desktop Background. Do you know what happens when you use the New option? With the use of the New option, you can get a new paint file or a new page. Do you know what is the shortcut command for New? The shortcut command for New is Ctrl plus N. Let us learn by watching this video as to how and why we use the New option. In order to use the New option, you need to take your pointer to the top left side of the paint sheet, right on top, and you can see a drop-down button here. You can click on that, as is being shown in the video to you, and a box opens which has many options, and you have to find the option for New and click on that with the left button on the mouse or the touchpad, and a new paint sheet or a paint file opens for you. You can also use the shortcut command Ctrl plus N. Can you tell what happens when you use the Open option? With Open, you can open a previously saved file on your computer. To do this, you can also use the shortcut command, which is Ctrl plus O. Watch the video to know more about using the Open option in MS Paint. Let us now see in this video how we use the Open command for Paint. Again, you have to take your pointer to the top left corner, click on the drop-down button, and click on Open. As soon as you click on Open, a box opens where it shows you the address bar and a file name. So you should know where your file is that you want to open. A file which is already existing on your computer. If it is in desktop, you click on desktop, and then you can scroll up or down, or you can type the file name in the box for file name like this, but you should know the file name to be able to open it. Remember, you can also use the shortcut command Ctrl plus O to come to this box and then type the file name. If you don't know the correct file name, even after you have typed the file name and you click on OK, let's see what happens. If the correct file name has not been typed and you click on Open, the computer can show you an error. As you can see in this video, it says the file could not be found. So you click on OK, and now you can directly click on the file which you want and click on OK or Open. Once you do that, your file will open, and you can see in the title bar or on the top of the paint sheet that your computer Shiksha paint file has got opened. Let us now get to know about save and save as options. Can you tell why save is used? Using save, you can save any text you may have typed or picture or paragraph that you may have made on your paint page. This will then be available to you for viewing or use on your computer. For save, you can also use the shortcut command Ctrl plus S. Watch the video to learn more about saving the paint file. Let us now watch this video and see how we can save our paint file. To save, you need to bring your pointer to the top left side of the paint sheet or the screen, click on this drop-down button, and then click on the save option. As soon as you click on the save option, a box opens, as is being shown in the video, and it gives you the options of saving at different locations in your computer. So you could save your file. You need to know where you want to save, and even if you click on this drop down button, you can see different locations. So you could save it in desktop or in downloads or in documents or in pictures. Once, if you want to save it in the desktop, you should select desktop and then in the file name, give a name for your file. For instance, in the video, you can see we are typing computer Shiksha as the file name. Once you write the file name, you need to click on the save button and your file will get saved. You can also see that in the title bar, the same name appears. Now, if you want to check whether this file has been saved properly or not, you need to minimize the paint file that you were working on by clicking on the minimize button, which is on the right side, top right side of your screen. Click there to minimize it. And then when you see the desktop, you can see that on the desktop, your file has been saved with the name of computer Shiksha, as is also being shown to you in the video. So this is how you use the save option to save your paint file. Do you know why is the save as option used? With the use of the save as option, you can save your previously saved file after making any changes in it, either with the same name and at the same location or with a new name and at a new location. Watch the video and learn more about using the save as option. We will now see in this video how we can use the save as option. Save as allows you to work on an already saved file. For instance, you can see in the title bar, this file is computer Shiksha, the paint file. You can make some changes in the file or you can save it as it is at a different location on your computer with a different name. So now you can make any changes or draw a picture, and to save as, you have to bring your pointer here on the top left side. Click on the drop-down button and then click on Save As option. A box opens which shows you different locations on your computer where you can save your file. So you can save it in desktop. You can see the other locations which are downloads or documents or pictures. So wherever you want to save, you click on that location. Right now we have clicked on documents. And then let's change the file name also. We are changing the file name to CS and then click on the save button. So this file now gets saved as the CS file. As you can see in the title bar also, now it says CS and it has been saved in the documents folder. To see whether it has been saved, we can just minimize this current paint file, and then we have to click on my computer, double click on my computer, and it shows different locations. Click on documents because you had saved it in documents, and you can see that your CS file has been saved in the documents folder. So you can close this. This is how you will use save as. Do you know how you can set any drawing that you have made in paint on your computer desktop? To do this, after you make a drawing, you need to select the option for set as desktop background from the paint file menu. By doing this, you will be able to set your picture as the desktop picture on your computer. Watch the video to learn more about setting a picture as the desktop background. With the help of this video, we are going to now see how we can set as desktop background any picture or drawing that we have. For instance, in this video, we have a picture which has computer Shiksha written in the middle, and we want to set this as the desktop background. So we take our pointer to the top left side, click on the drop down button, and then click on set as desktop background. Once you click there, now you need to look at the desktop to see what change has happened. So you can minimize this current file by clicking here on the minimize button, and then you can see that that picture has been set in your entire desktop as the background. So this is how you will use the set as desktop background option. Next, you will all learn about some of the options for the view menu, like zoom, ruler, grid lines, and status bar. Can you tell what happens when you use the zoom option? With the use of zoom, you can increase the size of your page or decrease it. However, the default size of the page will be 100%. You can use zoom in two ways. Watch the video and learn how zoom is used. In this video, we are going to learn how we can use the zoom option of the view menu to see our page in a bigger size or smaller size. So first, take your pointer to the view menu, left click on it, and then you can see zoom in and zoom out. Zoom in is to enlarge the size. If you keep clicking on zoom in, the page will become larger in size. You can use the scroll bars on the bottom and on the right side to see what has happened in your page. So the whole page has become bigger. If you click on zoom out, the page size becomes smaller and smaller. If you want to bring it to the normal size, you have to just click on the 100% option. So as soon as you click on 100%, your page becomes normal size. This is how you can use the zoom option of the view menu. Do you know what are rulers? Ruler is like a scale which helps us in making drawings. These rulers are of two types, horizontal and vertical. Let us watch the video and know more about rulers. Let us watch this video and see how we can show and hide the rulers, which are of two types, horizontal and vertical. Click on the view menu and then click or select the rulers option. As soon as you tick mark or select the rulers option, you will see both the rulers, the vertical and horizontal ruler, and you can use this to make your drawings or type in your paint sheet. If you do not want to see the ruler and if you want to hide it again, you have to take your pointer again to the rulers option and once again click there so that the rulers get hidden. So this is how you can use the ruler option and you can also show or hide the rulers. Do you know what is a status bar? The status bar tells us about the status of the page. By watching this video, let us learn how we can show or hide the status bar. Let us watch this video to see how we can hide and show the status bar. If you see on your paint sheet at the bottom, as is being shown by the pointer, this entire area is the status bar. It tells you the status of your paint sheet. Now, to see how you can hide and show, go into the view menu, click there, and then click on status bar. The tick mark gets removed and you can see the status bar gets hidden. It is no longer visible. If you want to see the status bar again, you have to take your pointer again to the status bar option and click on the status bar option. The tick mark appears and the status bar is shown once again. So this is how you can hide or show the status bar on your paint sheet. Since we will be ending today's class here, you should all close your paint file and properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you have all learned how we can type in an MS Paint file, how we can make use of the keyboard, how you can change the text style or the font name, how you can change the text or font color, how you can increase or decrease the size of the text or the font, how to use the bold, italic and underline options. You also learned about using new, open, save, save as, and save as desktop background options. And then you also learned about the view menu bar options like zoom in, zoom out, ruler, and about the status bar. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.